that one. Oh boy. Is that almost a netter? Oh, it is, Carl. It is, it is. Stay on, boy. Stay on, boy. Stay on. Oh boy. Yes, sir. Looking for some green grass. There's some green grass right there, 9 feet. Come on, dude. Let me fluke upon a school of big, fat, golden slabs. Stupid as hell. You know what those look like. Oh boy, dude, this is a major weed bed, Kent. Major. Holy moly. Wow. Yeah, 10 feet deep and the weed's like 3-4 feet deep. There's weed and there's life down here. Don't know sure what kind of life. Nice if it's crappy life. Look at that, eh? Crappie on the weed bed in cold, ugly conditions. Ugly, the fish are freezing cold, but crappie magnet does it again. Hey, first crappie of the year. I know you're saying, come on, Carl, but it's first crappie of the year. I'm a happy man. Sometimes it's search and destroy. This morning has been search, 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 and one so far, but you know, the never give up. You've heard it before. That's what I'm doing right here and now. So put one in the box. We're going to call them out. He's maybe even 11 inches long, but he's the first cold water crappie of the year, late April in Northern Ontario. Let's put him in the well, show you how I'm doing it so you can do it and you can catch him and you can have fun too by slowly searching and destroying when the water's not even 50 degrees. Let's get back out, throw the float, try to catch some more crappie. Let's go. Here's the biggest thing I'm gonna show you. I'm fishing over 10 feet of water and the weed comes up 5 feet. So right here, I've got the float, okay? The little bobber stop is here and the bait's down there. So I've got it about 5.5 feet deep, okay? What I'm gonna do, because cold conditions and the wind and stuff, these fish are just really slow. Make it even deeper. So as the float goes down, I got a split shot to stop it, help it go down faster. That little crappie magnet is almost just pulling through that milfoil, the deep weed, going and bouncing above it. And because there's a little bit of wind, so it's not straight down like this, okay? It's a little bit of an angle. So I'm not really fishing the depth that I have the bobber stop, okay? It's that angle, the pendulum. If I want to get right into the weeds, I've got a 1/16 ounce little jig head there. I'll go to maybe 1/8, 5/32. It's about getting that bait right through where they are. They're not really aggressive. The water's cold. There's hardly any sun. They're sitting right amongst that weed, right near the tips of it. So that bait's got to go right through their nose, right by like this before they decide to. So you got to put that bait right where they are, adjust the float back and forth until they tell you where they are, then you'll catch them. There's one. Big crappie. Looks like a decent crappie anyway. Let's see. Small crappie. That's because I haven't been catching them. And look how slow he's fighting. You know why? Because it is dead, dead cold. And look how good he even grabbed it. He's a small one. He won't even go in the live well. Right down. Look at him. Shaking up. And I'll tell you another thing I did. I'll show you. Go on, you're too small. Look what I put on that little crappie magnet. You know what that is right there, right? Slab bite. A little bit of taste. When it's really cold, that's what it looks like right there. Crappie magnet. Slab bite. It's not an ad. These things actually catch. And they're good too because they're really smelly and stuff. And some of the competitor stuff is good too. It's scented. But you get one fish and it falls off. This one hasn't fallen off. They perfected the texture, the scent, the smell, and it definitely helps you when crappie are in cold water conditions. They don't want to eat. Great for ice fishing, but right now I put that on and I got bit. Not a scientist, crappie fisherman. See if we can get some more. See that? You saw that. Big gill. Oh, nice crappie. Nice crappie. That's what you want right there. Now we're getting a bit more respectable. See that? Whoa! Maybe later we'll actually be able to put on that fish fry and put up our dual basket deep fryer and have some first crappie of the year. They're not giants at all. We're hoping to get some big ones, but that's ones I like to eat too. I can get some nice fillets off there. You know, those big ones are fantastic for pictures and see them flopping on the surface and stuff, but you know, I respect this fishery, man. Let those big females go, produce more of those ones, the ones to eat. But in the deep south, think about that, man. These are the ones right there that feed a lot of families right there. Black crappie, white crappie, that's the size right there. 11 inch, perfect size for eating. I am gonna kiss you because I'm gonna have you and enjoy you later. Here I'm in 13 feet with no weed. I got my marker boy right on the edge where the weed starts. And you know, even with great GPS and waypoints, you can get disoriented. You have a marker like that, you just know where you're supposed to be. Gives you a reference right there. See them popping it? There's the weed starting again. To catch myself a crappie, that's what I need. A couple more big crappies. If there's 10, 11 inches in there, potentially there's 13s or 14s. I'm optimistic. I just gotta get them turned on. I got some slab bites. Put it on the hook. These little northern jigs, man, are awesome. Sharp, sharp, sharp. Let's put it back out. Marker boy's there. See where the fish are. On the spot. See if we can catch some more. The sun might inspire them. Oh boy. Uh-oh. I think Carl got a better crappie. Yep. Better crappie. Yes, yes, yes. Well, I'm going to show you how these things eat, man. I'll tell you why people love catching crappies. Look at that. Look at that. Down the yap, dude. I've got that thing just perfect now. I'll show you what I mean in a second here. Let me put him in the box, okay? I'll show you what I mean about adjusting floats. Here's the deal. When I first came in, had the first bite, I was about 5 feet down, okay? So now, here's the bobber stop right here. There's at the bottom. So yeah, it's about 5+. And I adjusted it back and forth, 4, 6 sometimes. I was touching the weed, 4. I got a couple small fish. Right now I got it just about perfect. So let's see. There's the bottom. Here's the top, about 5+. That's the deal. And I've got the marker boy there. And I'm putting it right over the weeds that are 10 feet deep. The weed comes up to about 6 feet. So you know it's going right over the top of the weed, right where they're sitting. And there's another one. Oh man, oh man. Wow. Wow. It's pretty cool when you take your time and figure it out, boy. That's half the fun for me. The other half is catching them and obviously enjoying a meal of crappie. But you guys are just a little too small to enjoy. Here's the thing with the jigs, man. Traditional jig, yeah, nice and sharp, you know, 1/8 ounce white. But the keeper is just like the standard ones you find on a lot of jigs. These Northern Tackle Supply ones, if you see the comparison, it has a keeper at the back end, like a real little pin. Fantastic. And then sharp, further back, setback hook. I totally believe when I'm fishing with crappie baits and stuff, I want that hook point and the curve as far back in the bait as possible for those ones that just nip at it. Then you get them up on the top, okay? The shorter shank hook sometimes, you miss those when the bait's a bit longer. So I got 1/8 ounce in a white. It's been catching some fish with me. Let me show you a couple other options these guys have, okay? So I'm using the white right here, and you can tell I don't play around. These are with the musthead, nice solid shank. You know, if I ever hook into a 2 or 3 pounder, you never know. You don't have to worry about the gauge opening up and stuff. They've got them. This is 1/8 ounce. I got them in pink. I got them in white. Pink, chartreuse, and white. That's all I need right here, right now, in late April to catch some crappies. This is my setup right here. Very light slip float. Look at that thing, just slides. And I got the float bobber stop here about 5 feet. One split shot to help bring the bait down quicker so the float sits more vertical, not horizontal. On the money end, right there, the Northern Tackle Supply little jig, little white chartreuse crappie magnet, and of course, that right there, the slab bite, been helping me catch crappie when the water is like 43 degrees and they really do not want to be aggressive, but I'm provoking them. They're coming up, smelling it, eating it. Let's get back to the action. Catch some more crappies to inspire you. Come to Ontario, catch our beautiful black crappie. Let's go. Whoa, boy, oh boy. Look at my rod bend, dude. Look at my rod bend. Big slab, just nice slab. Look at these rods. Man, wow, look at how that thing goes. Tell me that's not fun. Oh yeah, eater, eater. I love these ultralights, man. They just like feel like it's a monster. Oh my goodness, those hooks are just priceless. Crappie fishing, no matter what it is, good jigs are worth every single penny. Oh yeah, good eating size fish. Jigs are worth every single penny, the good stuff. I showed it to you. I'll show you again, but I mean, do not skimp on anything. I know it's crappie fishing. You don't have to use $15 jigs or minnow baits and spinner baits and things like that. But good jigs, worth every cent when you get the crappie of the day, like this next one. Let's see. They're getting bigger. The sun's coming out. Things are happening. The rod makes the fish look like they're 3 pounds. Just stopped. And I set, and there he was. Like there. And a better one. You want to go this way? That's better right there. That's what I was talking about right there. About 12 inch plus. Look, the whole chain of command, the right rod, crappie magnet, and definitely slab bites are helping me on a rainy, cool spring day getting the feed of crappie. Love it. In the box you go, little boy. In the box you go. Just had to slow down. This is the honest time. 2 hours of looking for weed beds. I went to history spots. You know what those are? Places where you caught fish when you want to catch them again, and they're not there. You got to discover, search, look for similar spots. Sometimes fish move, the weeds die off. There's different factors. But if you know that people have been catching fish the last few weeks and stuff, temperatures rise and they drop, and you got snow. It is Northern Ontario. Just be versatile. Look around. It's not a science. You just break down things about where to find them. When the water temperature is cold like that, keep altering your float. Find those deep weeds. And when the sun gets up, the temperatures rise, you know they're going to head towards the shallows again. But until they do that, we'll keep doing this to try to keep catching fish and have a fish fry. Here's what's important. I got my marker boy marking the specific area that I'm fishing, this deep weed bed. So I use that just as a reference. I don't just stay by it. But to my right, it was 12 feet going up to the rock shoal. The left-hand side, 7.5, 9 feet, all tapering, different holes and stuff. But the weed was higher or lower. It was different. And I found that by casting to the left, right to the center, I'm going to call that 12 o'clock. This here was 9 o'clock, 3 o'clock, just altering the position of the weed bed. The crappie move based on the wind, the rain, We had all kinds of different barometer changes and stuff, and they just move around. It could have been from the bait fish. It doesn't matter. They just moved in the weed. So I dissected the whole weed bed. Use your marker buoys as a reference spot, your sonar. But if you got the power poles or the micros or an anchor, anchor in different spots, dissect and dominate those weed beds, and you'll catch those crappie as well. I saw you. You laid it down. You laid it down. I saw you. And yeah, you're coming for dinner. It seems like those nicer crappies are laying it down and just holding on to it, not grabbing and running. You're not grabbing and running, are you? Nope, you're just holding it. Oh my God, I love those jigs. Just the right size for a couple of fillets, that's all. A couple, let's put it back out in the same spot. Now I've got my power poles down. I found a spot that's about 8.5 feet deep in this weed. So I put the poles down. So instead of staying on the trolling motor, I could do that. When the wind's pushing me like this, I'd rather just cast in front of the boat, not let the fish know I'm here, and hopefully just pluck a few right in front of me. All they see is that little bait there. They decide to just munch it. They're just grabbing it and laying down that float. The float's like vertical like this, and it just goes boop, and sits and stops. They're just holding it. They're not going anywhere. Some will take it and run, and your float will go. But some, it just stops. Slow, methodical for catching crappies. Whoa. Is that a crappie? Oh, nice one, dude. Oh, that's what we're fishing for right there. Get him, in the meat. Oh, I got him in the meat. That's what, oh, you see how dangerous that is? You see how dangerous it is? You can have the best hooks in the world, but when you get them in that membrane, oh boy, it can be dangerous. Right there, man, are they ever cold. Look how yellow they are. You know where he's sitting. Put him in the box, boys. Slowly but surely, working on dinner. Working on dinner. But 1-2 punch, you've heard it before. I'm going to say it again. Slab bite. It's like putting on a little piece of bacon on a sandwich. You know? You have a BLT. What's a BLT without the bacon? Boring. BLT, man, it's the bacon. In this case, slab bite. Let's see if we can do it again. That one hit it, the shock, and then laid it down. That's what you like. You know those good 12 inches are in here. You got to go through the smaller ones. Oh well. Catching crappie. I saw you. Good one too. Oh boy. He laid that down. I love when they do that, man. I know. Because if you ain't paying attention, you're going to miss those bites. Look at that. Man, he's just barely in the membrane too. Barely. Look at this. Look at it. Easy crappie. Look where he is. You got lucky right there. Look at that. A little bit of hard stuff. Look where easy it pops out. Oh boy. That's a handful right there. That's what I call crappie dinner in a good way. What are y'all having for dinner? Oh, it's just another crappie dinner. In this case, it's a real fun dinner. So basically all this is like clumps, dudes. And there's black holes in the clumps between the thick weed coming up like a tree, like right there. And as it goes by, those crappie are sitting about, I would say, 3 or 4 inches below in those black holes you can't see between the thick weed. And when as that bait just drifts by with the wind, and I twitch it and stuff, just now covering water, and drifts by in front of their nose, they just decide to just, boop. That's why it's so important to have the right depth. I shortened it a little bit, okay? So now it's about here. Had it before up to here, and I'm getting a few more bites, so maybe they're a little bit higher in the weed. And if the bites stop, I'll lower it again to get down inside. But that was a couple bites in a row, two that definitely were crappie. It went up and then down, so he popped it. Yep. Good one too. Laid it down. Well, I think he's a fryer. He laid it down again. Boy, oh boy, you guys are eating it so slow, you won't even show me. Eh? Waiting for that float to go down is a big mistake sometimes. Look at the hook pop out. Oh boy. Yeah. Fryer time. Let's put it back out. There's the marker. The far side of the weed bed. Dominating. Finding dominating. Love it. Love how they don't play around when you find them. Whoa. Look at this. Everything is in this area here, dude. Oh, good crappie too. Look at this. Oh, just eaters. So honest to God, just perfect eaters. We all love to catch big fish. Trust me, I love catching big fat slabs. But when I can catch them like this to eat, I am in crappie heaven, boys. Just good eaters. Oh, nice. Boom, 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 boom. Let's put it right back out again. Right back on the edge here. Where are we? I don't even have a slab bite on. This is much confidence I'm getting now. I don't even have a slab bite on. I'm gonna put it back out. Whoa. There's my marker boy again, reference. You would have no idea where that weed bed is other than your GPS, but specifically knowing how to dissect the whole weed bed by having a reference point. It's so important. I can't stress how important that is. There, uh-oh. I think what we asked for, yep, yay! Man, oh man, incredible when you start catching fish, how you feel. Now we're catching some crappies, eating size fish. Love it. But I know where they are. They're on the tip of that weed bed, right there. That's about the edge of the weeds right there. Oh yeah, oh boy, look at, I love when that rod bends, look at that. I love when that rod bends, dude. Look at that. What a scrapper. He's not even a giant, but he's got some beautiful girth to him. Look at him. Thick, solid crappie. Whew. Able to cull out some of those small ones, dude, with some real eaters. That's it right there. Going in there. So, catching black crappies, late April, where the first 2 hours I thought maybe it would be, I don't know, search and destroy, 2 days to find them. We searched, moved around, white chartreuse crappie magnet, white Northern jig head, deadly. Slip float, and the new TCB series by Leyland Lures and B&M is getting the job done. It's incredible with this wind. You get the bowl in the line, and you have to just, the pros and cons of it. You want that bait flowing, okay, you want flowing over the weed beds, over those pockets. So you want that float to sit upright, so you have to give it a bit of slack. But by doing that, you have the slack in the line too, okay? You gotta pick up that slack sometimes, and it's just the way it goes. But it's nice with these little reels, they pick up that slack, so you can make the cast. What I do is I pick up the line, bring it down like this. It helps a bit. So I'm watching the float, it hits the bobber stop, the float goes vertical. So anything happens, especially if it lays down, and the way these crappie have been biting, it's just like, it's going, and all of a sudden it's just like electricity, doop, and then it goes down. Or go sideways. It's incredible. So subtle because of the cold water. But the whole combination, the rods, sensitivity, the persistence would help you catch those crappie when the water's cold. We need a couple good ones, man, in a row. If we can usually catch just some nice big silver and green, beautiful crappies. that one. Oh boy. Is that almost a netter? Oh, it is, Carl. It is, it is. Stay on, boy. Stay on, boy. Stay on. Oh boy. Yes, sir. Carl gets a picture of fish. Carl gets a picture of crappie. That's it right there. That's what I'm looking for right there. There's the picture fish with the slab, with the crappie magnet right there. There's our picture right there. It's a female. I'll show you. I will let her go. But that's it right there. 14-inch, beautiful, black and gold. Look at the belly. It's going to be spawning soon, going shallow. But for now, catch a nice big one, net it, take some pictures, and we'll let her go. Look at that, eh? Aren't they gorgeous fish? Love the crappies, man. Love them. Go on, boy. See your friends for a bit. Dwarf those eaters. But that's the deal. Marker's there. I moved right to the edge of the weed bed, like before, zigzagging around. It just seems like they're in that. As soon as the sun came out, temperature rose a little bit, wind went down, rain left. Those big ones pulled to the edge of the weed bed. For whatever reason, wind's coming from that way, bait fish, who cares? But me moving around on that weed bed, putting the power poles down every time, but having that orange thing right way back there. See that right back there? There's my reference. It hasn't moved since we started. Shows me everywhere I am because of that. Those are worth every penny. Marker boy thing. That deep weed where they come out. We had a snowstorm last week. When those fish pull out a little bit, they gang right up. It's your job to find them. So we stuck with it. The crappie magnet with the slab bite, altering the depth of the slip float back and forth, dissecting that weed bed because it was altered back and forth. I fished probably two or three weed beds that were very similar, but didn't have the same thickness of the weed that tapered up and down. Some weed beds were like almost just flat. The one that I found that I caught a lot of fish on was all tapering, 7, 9, 10 feet. The weed were up and down. And what that is those holes in the weed, the dark holes that you can't see. Those fish were just sitting positioning like that. And when that bait just drifted by with the long lead, they saw the crappie magnet with the slab bite, it was done. Appreciate you watching. Hope you learned something about fishing in the northern lakes in late April. When the water is 43 degrees, you'll catch them too. Appreciate you watching. We're going to see you, man, next time on all your social media platforms and as well worldwide on TV. See you next time.